Hello students, good morning. This is my second lecture. In the first lecture we studied the basics, the introduction of classification. Today we are going to study how different factors contribute to animal classification. There are different basis on which animal classification is based, and one of them is symmetry. So now we will study how symmetry leads to classification of animals. The basic thing about symmetry is its definition. What is symmetry? Now symmetry, if we try to define it, suppose this is a structure. Now we define symmetry as division of body into equal parts, division of body into two or more equal parts by a plane which passes through the center of the body. See, this is a body. This is a center. This is the center of this body. Any plane which passes through the center of body and divides it into equal parts, this is called as symmetry. Now if you see, if I take this plane, it also passes through the body, but it divides the body into two unequal parts. So the main thing is the plane should pass through the center of body. So we define symmetry as division of body into two or more equal parts by any plane which passes through the center of body. Now on the basis of this definition, symmetry in animals is classified into four basic types. The first type of symmetry is radial, and the second is biradial, which is again a type of radial symmetry. Then the next is bilateral, and the fourth one is spherical. These are the four types of symmetry which are found in organisms. Now if we see spherical and radial, these are two very related type of symmetries, because when we see radial symmetry and spherical symmetry, the definition is somewhat similar. See, the radial symmetry is defined as division of body into one or more equal parts by number of planes which pass through the center of body. See, any plane which will pass through the center of body will divide this organism into equal parts. The basic concept of radial symmetry is that it is found in organisms which are cylindrical, which are either cylindrical in shape or umbrella in shape. Now if you see, suppose this is Hydra. If you see, the body is cylindrical and this is a jellyfish. Okay. Now if you see the jellyfish, it is umbrella in shape. So the organism which show radial symmetry, they have the body either in the form of cylinder or in the form of a umbrella, sub-umbrella surface. Now if you see this jellyfish, if I put this jellyfish on this figure, this is the center of body. Any plane which will pass through the center of body will divide this jellyfish into equal parts. Now if I take this Hydra, and if I try to divide this into equal parts, it will not be divided into equal parts. So the definition of radial symmetry says the division of body into two or more equal parts by a longitudinal plane. See, if I take this Hydra in this longitudinal plane and it divide it into any plane, it will be divided into equal parts, just like this circle. So the plane is important. In radial symmetry, the plane should be longitudinal to the center of body. Now radial symmetry is an adaptation. It is an adaptation. It's found mainly in sea dwelling organism and organism which are sedentary or attached. They do not move much in their life, because this type of symmetry has sensory organs in all the directions of the body. Sensory organs are present. So they can collect food from all direction. Food can be collected from all directions, and they can also sense danger from all direction. So the first type of symmetry which arose in animal kingdom was radial symmetry, and this is when we study evolution, then we see why radial symmetry gave rise to biradial, why it gave rise to bilateral, and why to spherical. Now when we go to the spherical symmetry, spherical symmetry is the same as the radial symmetry. Any plane which passes through the center of body will divide it into equal parts. So when we say the definition is same, what is the difference? The difference is this. See, in the spherical symmetry, the organism is in form of a sphere. But in radial symmetry, the organism was cylindrical or umbrella in shape. So when any plane which passes through the center of body of this organism or this organism will divide it into equal parts. But spherical symmetry, in spherical symmetry, the body is in form of sphere. Examples like Volvox, Radiolarians, Heliozoans. That is, if we see the group, that is Protozoa. So a question is asked in many competitive exams, which type of symmetry is the first to be found in animal kingdom? So we have studied two. First is radial and second is spherical. Now radial symmetry is found where? Radial symmetry is found in some young sponges. See, when I say young sponges, young poriferans, the older ones or the adult ones become asymmetrical. So porifera is not classified into radially symmetrical organism. But if we see some young sponges like Leucosolnia and Cycan, these two are example of radially symmetrical poriferans. So young sponges, they have radial symmetry. And then when we go to Cylindrata, that is now it is called as Nidaria or Cylindrata, these poriferans, Nidarians and Echinodermata, these are three examples where radial symmetry is found. So young sponges, Leucosolnia and Cycan. Second is Nidaria, phylum Nidaria, and third is Echinodermata. Now if anyone of you remember any example of Echinodermata, see, starfish. Now starfish has a pentamerous radial symmetry. Five planes which will pass through the center of body will divide it in equal parts. It depends how many arms it has. So if five arms are present, it will divide it into five equal parts. If six arms, so it depends. So Echinodermata, Nidaria and Leucosolnia Cycan, they show radial symmetry. Now when I go to spherical, so the question is, which type of symmetry is the first to be found in animal kingdom? Any answer, whether it's radial or spherical? See, it's not spherical. We see here protozoa. Now protozoa is not included into kingdom Animalia. So the first type of symmetry which is found in kingdom Animalia is radial and it is not spherical. We have to remember this for competitive exams. Stop. The next type of symmetry is biradial symmetry. Now see, biradial symmetry is just a type of radial symmetry. The organisms here is still in the form of umbrella shape. For example, Ctenophora. Now see, in Ctenophora, it includes the comb jellies. If you see the structure of comb jellies, the comb jellies, they are just like two jellyfishes, but they have two long tentacles which usually use out from the body. So the body can be divided into two equal parts by only two planes which pass through the center of body. As soon as we try to divide it in equal parts through the third plane, the division of the tentacles or the internal organs becomes asymmetrical. That's why Ctenophora is an example of biradial symmetry, and which is a type, just a type of the radial symmetry. So the only minor phylum which shows the biradial symmetry is Ctenophora. The next is the bilateral symmetry. See, the rest all phylums, they show bilateral symmetry. Now, what are the rest phylums? See, we have seen Porifera. Porifera are largely asymmetrical. We saw some exceptions like Leucosolia and Cycan, which are radially symmetrical. Next, phylum Ctenophora is biradial. Now, when we go ahead of the Ctenophora ke ahead Eskelmans, Nemethelmans, Annelida, the rest invertebrates. Okay, so it's better to write it as rest invertebrates plus all chordates. Now, all chordates includes all the amphibians, reptile, apes, mammals, proto, the cephalochordata and the urochordates. They are all showing bilateral symmetry. And one very important example of bilateral symmetry, which is usually asked in exams, is the larva of Echinoderma. See, the larva of Echinodermata. If you remember, when I was explaining radial symmetry, I told you that radial symmetry is found in Echinodermata. But when I talk about the larva of Echinoderms, like the trochophore, when I talk about the larva of Echinoderms, like the Pluteus larva, the Pluteus larva shows bilateral symmetry. Ophiopluteus larva shows bilateral symmetry. So the Echinodermata is classified into radiata or bilateralia. This we will see later, where they are classified, whether they are bilaterally symmetrical or they are radially symmetrical. Now, see, bilateral symmetry, why does it develop? Why did radial symmetry give rise to bilateral symmetry? Why this symmetry was needed in evolution of the further animal? See, when we talk about radial and biradial symmetry, they are found in usually sedentary organism. Example, if you see Hydra, it moves sometimes, but it is mostly found attached. Okay, so the cylindrates and Leucosolnia, Cycan, they are sedentary and water dwelling, so they can collect food from all sides. That's why they have radial symmetry. But when organisms evolved, then the locomotion started, and when locomotion started, directed motion started, there arose a need. See, suppose this is an organism. Now, if this organism is moving, this is the front side, this organism is moving in this side, and the sensory organs, see, when it will move, it will need concentration of sensory organs on the interior part, which we called as the head. The head or cephalization started, so that's why the sensory organs, the nose, eyes, ears, the tongue, it started becoming concentrated on the interior side. So the bilateral symmetry was an adaptation for locomotion, because when animals started locomoting, they needed the sensory organs to be situated on the interior part. Now, the definition of bilateral symmetry says that a division of body into two equal parts, only two equal parts, by a plane which passes through the center of body. This is how we define. Now see, suppose this is a fish. If I take, this is the center of body. Now if I divide this fish from this center of the body, it is divided into two equal parts? No. See, this part has eye, this part has tail. So this is unequal division of the body. Now if I divide the body into two parts through this plane, this is plane A, this is part B. Now, do you see, are they equal? No. See, the A part has eyes. The B part does not have eye. So, what is bilateral symmetry? Which plane divides the body into two equal parts? See, the plane which divides the animal into two equal parts is called as the sagittal axis. Now, what is sagittal axis? See, suppose this is an organism. You all know this is a frog. Okay. Now, if you see, this is the back part of the frog. The back part of the frog is the dorsal side, and the side away from the sun is the ventral side. Now, if I try to divide, suppose this is the center of body. If I divided this unequal, if I try to divide this organism into this plane, if you see this plane, the organism will be divided into two equal parts, two eyes, the mouth part will be divided, the hands will be divided equally, the legs will be divided equally. So this is how the organism will be divided into two equal parts. So this axis is called as the sagittal axis. Now, what is sagittal axis? It is mid ventral longitudinal axis. Mid ventral, see, this is the ventral side, this is the dorsal side. So this is the mid dorso ventral axis, which will divide the body into two equal parts. So this axis is called as the sagittal axis or the mid dorsal mid ventral longitudinal axis. Now see, if I put this fish like this, this is the dorsal side of the fish. So when I see the dorsal side of the fish, I can see both the eyes. Now when I divide this fish through the sagittal axis, the body will be divided into two equal parts. Both part have eyes, both part have tail fin, they are similar. So this is how this axis will divide the organism into two equal parts. Now if you see, the organism which have bilateral symmetry, they have the left side and they have the right side. The left and the right side can be identified only in the bilateral symmetry. If you see this, now this is a jellyfish having a radial symmetry. Now it does not have, I'll turn it like this, you cannot identify the right and the left side. So the right and the left side can be identified in the bilateral symmetry. So this axis is important. Which axis divides the organism into two equal parts? So the answer is sagittal axis. Thank you.